Chiama pure il mio nome e lo sai che ovunque sarò. Gosh, it sounds so much better in English. Ciao e benvenuti su LIS, Learn Italian Songs, Learn Italian with Songs. Io sono Pietro and in this channel we listen to famous Italian songs and we translate the words word by word. And we throw in just some hints of cultural information and some bits of grammar here and there. And today we're going to listen to a song which is not so famous. It's First Me, Second Me, sung by none other than James Taylor. And today we're going to translate what might look as a real outsider to this series, but upon close examination, it is not. On the contrary, if you look at it the right way, this song will provide you with a wealth of ready-to-use Italian sentences and idioms. But why, oh why, could you mistake it for an outsider of the LIS, Learn Italian Songs, Learn Italian with Songs series? Well, it's because it's a song in English. Okay, I have the feeling that this might be one of the least watched videos so far, but I challenge you to prove me wrong with your views and your likes, so watch until the end, hit the thumbs up, and why not subscribe to the channel? Today we're going to translate a tune sung by none other than James Taylor, yes, the one who wrote You Just Call Out My Name, and you know the rest. Well, I am willing to bet that there are lots of die-hard James Taylor fans who have never heard of this song. Now, the song was actually written by Italian superband Elio e le Storie Tese, who are sometimes defined as a band which plays musica demenziale, which we could more or less translate as nonsense music. But I think that they make more sense than most Italian singers. The song is called First Me, Second Me, and it is divided into two parts. And I will be singing and analyzing the second part, which is called Second Me. The one originally performed by James Taylor on the record Eat the Fig is from 1996. And why is this song so very useful for learners of Italian? Because it is a collection of Italian sentences translated exactly word by word in English, which is what we do here on LIS, only the other way around. Now, I have never told you this with regards to the other songs, because I thought, well, it goes without saying, but I will say it now. Go find the original. Go find all the original songs that you hear on this channel. And you can easily find this one on YouTube, you just type Second Me, James Taylor, and it will pop up. I use this song all the time when I teach English in a lesson entitled What Not to Say in English, or a collection of wrong English sentences. But if you watch it from a different perspective, it will help you learn a lot of very useful Italian sentences. So, without further ado, here is the song with the written translation and explanations will come next. See you soon.
How you call you? How many years you have, from where come, how stay? Not to be said, the life is a thing wonderful, and I am here to make it wonderfuler. Not see the mile of for yourself, for force not is visible. Not hear the sound of my guitar, it's played for you. It's played for me, it's played for we. Je t'aime, je t'aime. Must to be the my girl, come on, the my car that I bring you at May Quantour. what think of the my car? It's much beautiful, second me.
So, on to the translation again, and as it has happened for two of the previous songs, Va Pensiero and the Italian National Anthem, I have recorded two explanation sections for this translation, and the first one was quite messy, as you can see here. I was trying to be too detailed, and things got very confused and confusing pretty soon, so I decided to eliminate the handwritten paper that you have seen during the performance of the song and pass or continue with a printout here. And so here you have the song. Now, in this episode, we will learn how to say in Italian some basic sentences such as what's your name, how old are you, where are you from, and more. We will also learn how to cheer someone up by saying don't be sad, life is a wonderful thing. We will finally pose more philosophical questions and throw some flirty invitations, and all thanks to today's song. Now, this is an unusual LIS lesson where we reverse engineer some Itanglish sentences to get insights on the way Italians structure their language. Now, for this purpose, I have prepared some multicolored notes, and the color code is the following. In blue, you will see the target sentence in English, okay? In red, you will see the English word that Italian natives would actually think about when translating that sentence word by word from Italian to English. Now, these red sentences are, most of the times, the actual words of the song. And in black, you will see the sentence in regular Italian, which is what you care about, I think. So, in other words, the explanation process will be as follows. In blue is, do you want to learn how to say so and so written in blue in Italian? And in red, well, we Italians actually think it like this, blah blah blah. So this will be in red. And so we say the sentence the way it is rendered in the song. And in black you will be, and the standard Italian sentence is, so when you have to use your Italian, you will pronounce, you will say the black sentence. Okay, on to the title. Second Me is the second part of First Me, Second Me, and it means, as we will see in the end, according to me, or in my opinion, or I think, I reckon. So do you want to learn how to say what's your name in Italian? We Italians think this sentence as how do you call yourself? But since we do not use the auxiliary do in questions or in negative sentences, we would think about how you call you, which is the line of the song. And how you call you, what's your name in Italian, is come ti chiami. How do you call yourself? Then, do you want to learn how to say how old are you? How to ask how old are you? In Italian, we are not old or young. We possess, so to say, years. So we ask how many years do you have, but since in Italian we don't use the auxiliary do, we would think about how many years you have. And so how old are you in Italian is quanti anni hai, how many years do you have. And then, you want to learn how to ask where you come from? Well, we Italian don't use the do, as I told you before. So, from where come? The word order is this. So, where do you come from in Italian is da dove vieni, from where do you come? And then, if you want to ask how somebody is doing, so if you want to ask how are you, we actually think about how do you stay, because we use this verb, the verb stare, and so we ask how stay, funny, ain't it? And then when we want to tell someone don't be sad, we think about not to be sad, because This is the infinitive of the verb. The verb to be in Italian is essere. So don't essere, sad is triste. Then it proceeds by saying, life is a wonderful thing, but we would structure this sentence differently in Italian. The life, because we love our articles, the life is a thing wonderful. In Italian, it's not like in English, we are not obliged, we are not forced to put the adjective before the noun. So many times, the sentence sounds more natural when we put it after the noun. So, life is a wonderful thing. In Italian would be la vita, life. The life is a wonderful thing. Okay, the life is a thing wonderful. And I am here, this is just like in the song, for once, e io sono qui, and I am here, word for word, to make it more wonderful. But sometimes, when we Italians are learning the comparatives, we learn the rule that you just slap an ER at the end of the word, and there you have the comparatives. We forget that for some long words, the rule does not apply. So the line of the song is for make it wonderfuler or to make it wonderfuler, and it means and I am here e io sono qui per farla più meravigliosa, to make it more wonderful. Per farla is to make it, but in standard Italian we would say per renderla più meravigliosa. Both are correct, but maybe this one, renderla, is more elegant. So if you want to ask someone, don't you see my love for you, or can't you see how I love you? Can't you see how I love you? We would think this sentence as not see the my love for yourself. Remember that we don't use the don't auxiliary. So can't you see how I love you? Not see the my love for yourself. Non vedi il mio amore per yourself, te. And then it proceeds by saying, of course, you can't physically see love. It's a feeling. It's not something that you can see with your eyes. So, of course, it's not visible. Okay, but of course, we would translate it this with another idiom. For force, not is visible. Per forza is another way of saying, of course. You could say, of course, as in Italian, you could render it as certamente, but also as per forza. For force, not is visible. It's not visible, not is visible. Per forza, non è visibile. And then, can't you or don't you hear my guitar playing? We Italians would think something like, not hear the sound of my guitar. So it would be non senti il suono della of the I forgot one letter L. Should be della with two L's. Della mia chitarra. Can't you hear the sound of my guitar? Not hear the sound of my guitar. It's played by me. If you want to say it's played by me here, the passive form is a bit tricky for us Italians. So we would say is played from me, because in Italian it sounds something like è suonata da me, and da usually is translated with from, as in where are you from, da dove vieni. It's played for you. Once again, is played for you. This is very similar. È suonata per te. My guitar is played for you. It's played for us, but many times we students of English have a hard time learning the pronouns, object pronouns. So many times we confuse us with we. So it's played for us, we would say it's played for we, and so è suonata per noi, us. And then it proceeds by saying, yes, I love you, but it says it in French, so it has nothing to do with the English. And it says, oui, je t'aime, si, ti amo, this needs no explanations. And then, you must become my girlfriend. This is sort of an imperative, okay? Or sort of a very convinced suggestion. Must to be the, my girl, once again, essere the infinitive of the verb to be, is often translated by beginner students of English as to be. Devi essere la mia ragazza, okay? Must to be essere the my girl. Okay, you must be my girlfriend. You must become my girlfriend. And then it says, jump in my car or hop on, okay? Come on, the my car. Notice the use of the everywhere, which is vieni, sulla, on the my car. Come on, the my car, jump in my car. So I can take you for a ride. We would say that I bring you at make one tour. That I bring, porto you, at make one tour, so that I can take you for a ride. And then there's the final question, what do you think about my car? But once again, we don't use the do auxiliary. So we would say, what think of the my car? Cosa pensi della of the is della D plus la my car. What do you think about my car? It's very beautiful in my opinion, or I guess, or I think it's very beautiful. It's much or is much beautiful second me. Is much beautiful second me, then it means è molto bella, secondo me. Now learn this idiom, secondo me. It means in my opinion, okay? It's very beautiful, in my opinion, second me. And this ends the translation.
You've come this far. Bravo, complimenti. Now, if you liked this video, hit the thumbs up, subscribe, and share. You know, these things I hear all the time on YouTube, and they say it helps with the algorithm, so why not help me if you like this video and want to see more? Don't forget that in the description below you can find links to useful resources for Italian learners. And until next time, arrivederci!